It was back in 1986. The trees seemed to be sleepy. The roads were almost empty. Here came three legends to St. Joseph's College, Bangalore. One military man with love as delicate as pollen. A humble mycologist with his unending love for mushrooms. And a young heart who loved coffee and DNA equally. They were eager to learn, eager to teach, oblivious to their own caliber. They toiled to spread the knowledge, they nourished the young minds. They are the best friends we ever had. As clock ticks and time draws nearer, we all BW, the last day, the last hour, the last batch. So today we are here to listen to the stories of our dearest lectures.
1965, I finished my master's degree from Manasabhavutri Mysore. The way I came to St. Joseph's was a bit strange. I still remember one night I just went to a provision stores and asked for some groundnut. He tore a piece of paper and packed the groundnuts in it. Normally my habit is, whenever there is a piece of paper, even it may be anything, I never used to throw. I used to go through the paper and then throw. After I came home, after eating the groundnut seeds, I just looked, it's a very small piece of paper. I still remember it's a decathlon paper of more than a week or so. There is a small advertisement, wanted lecturer in botany for St. Joseph's College. And I applied for it. I had just passed my MSc, so I did not even know whether I would be called for interview. After about a week or so, I received a letter from the then principal, Father Menezes, a postcard at that time, that I am called for interview. I was not hopeful because it was the first time I came to Bangalore. And I still remember that day, I took a bus early in the morning. It was raining, and with all apprehension of almost a rural folk, Mysore was a practical village. Okay, Bangalore was something very big. It was raining, and I had a long grandfather umbrella. I was not a grandfather. And I walked into St. Joseph's College after traveling in an auto. And I still remember many of them looked at me with disbelief. Who is this Rip Van Winkle coming with a long umbrella? Because I had not even seen that. Since it was raining, I had that old-fashioned umbrella. And I entered the interview room. There were about 10 to 12 others. So I thought my chances nil, because they were all experienced from that room. And as they say, suited and booted and all those things. And do you know who were the interview board? Father Menezes, Professor Shamana, Professor Doyle, and Father Sushil Saldana. I am sure you must have heard his name, the celebrated taxonomist. At that time, I was a brash youngster. That means without bothering who is asking, who is anything, just tell whatever you want, with brutal frankness. Then what happened was, at that time I was thinking that taxonomy and other classical branches of botany are useless. The only thing that we have to learn is physiology, genetics, and all those things. And I did not know that Father Saldana was a taxonomist. Of course, my answers would not have made much difference even if I were to know that he is a taxonomist. And then in the interview, Father Menezes asked one or two basic questions. And then Father Saldana asked, what is your idea of taxonomy? I said, it's a useless subject. There is no modernity in it, just collection of plants. But he said, whatever research you will do, but don't you think knowing the name of the plant is essential? That I said, we can always obtain the name, but there is nothing great about that branch. Then do you like it? He asked me. I said, no. And then Professor Shamana, he was the head of the department. He asked me, which branches do you like? I said, physiology, genetics, and other things. Then he asked me a pointed question. What is the product of Krebs cycle? Before it goes into Krebs cycle, what is the product? I said, two molecules of acetaldehyde. He was very much pleased because he did not even say acetaldehyde. He said, two molecules of acetaldehyde. He said, good. Then they said, you can go. Then afterwards, normally we exchange other interviews, other things. Then they said, what question they asked you? I said, there is a priest who asked me about tax. Oh, there is Father Soldan, I said. He said, what question they asked me, what question he asked about taxonomy? I said, it is a useless subject. Your chances are gone, they said. He is a taxonomist himself, and you are derailing his own subject. Why did you say? Then I thought, first of all, I thought I'm from Mysore, there is no influence, and obviously somebody else would be taken. So I just forgot all about it and went back to Mysore. Do you know, after about another 5-6 days, I was shook with surprise, I was shaken with surprise rather, because I was appointed. You have been appointed, please come and report to duty. I didn't believe first of all. And then in any case, I came here and then report duty. Father Sadhana was there. Then I said, thank you. At that time, honestly, I'm telling you, I used to address them as sir because I had not worked in a Catholic institution. I did not even know that I would address them as father. Subsequently, of course, I learnt. Then, after Father Sadhana became a bit familiar, then I asked him, Father, I derided your subject. But then, why did you select me? He said, all others answer question and taxonomy. I too know it is a dry subject. To please me, they will tell you they like their subject. You are the only person who spoke truth. You are the only person. I said, it is because of that I selected you. After all, any branch, anything you can learn. But truth is most important. That is why I selected you. The three colleagues of mine, I still remember. Betty Bhagyam, at that time she was not married. I think subsequently she became Betty Daniel. Yeah. Yeah. Betty Bhagyam, then Purushothama, and then
Jacob
Abraham. Jacob Abraham, I did not know because I taught him. He was my student in PhD. Right? I used to like him. He was very active in botanical studies, and I wholeheartedly welcome him to the department. And we appointed a number of people when we got the PG course. So that is how Purushothama did his PhD, I think, if I am right, from Madras University, correct. Because his brother was there as a professor of Kannada, Mariyappa Gowda, I think, if I am right. He was there as a Kannada professor. And Betty Bhagyam also came from Delhi. And another thing about this institution I should tell, they never had regional feelings, that they should appoint only these people, that people, all these things. And everybody who is fair, who is good. In fact, you see, when I was in the interview, I used to ask very strict questions, ask them very strict questions. And the management also, I'm telling you, in many instances, they will have their own preferences. Interview is a drama. It is not like that. See, choice was given to me because the principal or the others, at that time, used to say, you are the one to work with them afterwards. So you select, we don't have any other things we look after. But subject-wise, you have to take care of it. And I should say, my belief in them was never believed. Both of them had, all the three of them had interest in learning. They were very good and extremely genial character and attitude, all the three of them had. So I don't have anything else to say except all very good things because they are very fine individuals. See, we can tell fine with adjectives. But one word, fine human beings, tells everything. Is it not so? I think that's all I can tell.
I joined the department in the year 1984, way back. And then at that time, just we were 5 or 6 of us. Later on, within the period of 2 years, with the intention of starting a postgraduate course in botany, more teachers were added. So we had at that time Betty ma'am also, when I joined in 84. So Betty ma'am was there, and then subsequently Purushottam, then Jacob Abraham, all three they were there, and my first impression of Betty Mom was that she was a very, as far as microbiology is concerned, she was a very knowledgeable lady. You ask her anything in microbiology, she had a ready answer. So that is one impression I had. One thing about Betty is that she believes in giving freedom to the students. So many a times students mistake that she doesn't guide. I think that is the best way to encourage creativity, is to just leave the students to their own. This basically is NCBS character. In Institute of Science or NCBS, students are given maximum freedom. I think Betty Ma'am has a balance of this. Because of this, she is even treated as very strict also. At the same time, she is liked by the students, because some who like freedom in research, they really appreciate, because she won't interfere much at all. But this basically is the character of all higher institutions of learning in our country, like IISc, NCBS or IITs. Mostly students are left to their own fate. So Betty Ma'am's style was successful at that time. Her teaching, along with the net, I think, interaction always she used to do, was liked by many students, and her strictness also is appreciated. As a result, she is really an embodiment of a teacher who is very popular. So this is my thing, the thing. But Betty was popular, and Betty was knowledgeable, and Betty was also many a times innovative in her approach of teaching. Her approach, I think, if you know those who have studied under her, is unique. It doesn't match with any of the thing. You can't say she's like me, or you can't say like any. That, of course, is a teacher. That's how to be. So with this, and then one thing, her personal habits, I know. Coffee, you give her any amount, she will not say no. This is one thing. So I used to always say, Betty, should we have coffee? Yes, she will say. Anytime she would not say no. And also, she used to like good food. So she would tell that we together used to visit some restaurants around Bangalore. So many of the new restaurants she knows is because of me, you can ask. So that is the thing. Jacob Abraham was a Josephite, very much. Dr. Jacob Abraham, or Professor Jacob Abraham as such, was a Josephite. So much of the things that I share are with Professor Jacob Abraham. Particularly, was very fond of poetry. I am known as a haiku poet, so I write a lot of haiku poetry. And he would always come and ask, how is your poetry going? If I had written anything new, he would ask. And other things that are not well known about our Jacob Abraham is that he is an athlete. He represents the university. So his good physics is a result of he being an athlete. And in most of the functions of the college, he is to be there, either as a, what we can say, anchor person, or a master of ceremonies, and is to do a wonderful job of that. And we mutually is to share, because we are from the same culture of this Josephite, from St. Joseph's College. So it's a pleasure that two Josephites were in the same department, and we used to interact a lot. And subsequently, some of our students, they became part of the staff. Those days, we used to have long botanical tours. For example, longest I took the student was for 15 days. And it was a long trip from Kanyakumari to Pune, entire Western Ghat. So they used to remember that. So whatever hill stations used to come, I think Jacob Abraham used to accompany, Purushottam used to accompany. First they thought Naeem is a very strict person, he'll be very boring to have company. But when they came along, and I used to crack jokes and other things, they used to appreciate. We never thought Naeem is such an interesting company. We thought he's a very strict and very, what we can say, reclusive person. He may not speak very much and it will be boring. Then Jacob Abraham and others, they went along with our another person who was very fond of traveling, was Charles Suresh. So Professor Charles Suresh, Jacob Abraham, and some few more from other departments, together they went on to Andamans. Another 15-day trip on their own. Not students, just on their own. Similarly, colleges to arrange for Northeast one trip. So some of them visited Northeast through those things. As a result, we were very fond of field botany. So we would go. And at that time, a very interesting person was, you can hear him, was Sundar Rajan. He again was almost like, I would say, it is the plants that will talk to Sundar Rajan. It is not the Sundar Rajan who will know the plants. So plants will directly talk to Sundar Rajan and he will know more about their personal details, if I would say. At that time, our college had an estate in Ooty. And so we all used to stay in that estate very comfortably and make lot of trips around Ooty and collect plants. In our own lifetime, right near Lal Bagh and in Nandi Hills, we used to collect Markensia, remember. So now I think natural Markensia, which is a bryophyte, I don't think you have seen anywhere. But those days, if you go to Ooty, there was Markensia. Now as the population of tourists has increased, pollution has increased, these plants have disappeared. And in this campus itself, we used to find Rickettsia growing. So now Purushottam, again a very interesting thing. So Purushottam again, he was from Karnataka. He went to Tamil Nadu, picked up very fluent Tamil. And if you see he talking with Saran, you would think he must be a native Tamilian. He again was a very meticulous teacher. So as far as practicals are concerned, he was thorough. And he would teach in a very simple manner all those fungal material or pathological material that was there in a systematic manner. And his own field of research, he never left, mushrooms, which he guided some students and discovered a new species in Bangalore of mushroom, edible mushroom, which is this big. So, and I think they have patented that, and his research student is a patent expert now. She must have come and given a... But Purushottam again was very simple. You will never know that he knows so much. But the moment you interact with him, he will say, no, Naeem, this is how it is. I think this is the correct way and this is the right way to attack this particular research problem. And then he would also guide in a very gentle manner his PhD students as far as research is concerned. I don't think he was strict. I would say Betty used to give more freedom. I think Purushottam also used to give lot of freedom, but with lot of interference now and then, checking that this is how this has to be done.
We were all otherwise. Classical botany teachers with algae, fungi, bryophyte, pteridophyte, gymnosperms, morphology of angiosperms, embryology, cytology, genetics, evolution. Until there was a big break when Father Nelapathy called me and Dr. Naeem and said, why don't you start postgraduate courses, MSc courses? Then the department had its golden era of academic excellences because we got some of the young, highly qualified, extraordinary batch of staff. We became a very closely knit family. So to me, Bopaya became Bopsi. Then your Betty became Betty Ma. They were all young, they were very beautiful, they were very smart. Prema Gunashili was there, Jacob Abraham was a young man. All of them were bachelors, spinsters. So it was a beautiful environment of pioneers, I should say, in this field. So I used to think Dr. Betty Daniel as a Madame Curie. If Madame Curie can get two Nobel laureates working in a car shed on radiation, Betty Ma could get a few PhDs and MPhils from a very small place, because the potentiality was not in the building, it was within. That was the capacity of the staff that were in this department. and total autonomy was given to each and every student, to the student as well as to the staff. So they said, we'll start honors programs in Botany. Said, yes, we'll have honors programs. Then there was honors program on one hand, PhD program on the other, the undergraduate programs in yet another, with MPhils, PhDs. To this institution called St. Joseph's, which has given us everything. The trust. I go to the principal and say, Father, I have a huge bill for you because we are starting so many courses. Father will look at me like this. Hey Charles, asking thing is your duty, man. Bringing money is mine. You'll be surprised. College went and got an overdraft from Indian Overseas Bank. College went into debt to establish our department, but still said yes for everything. So how would you go and ask such a management and tell you increase our salary? We did not want salary. We wanted these academic values, virtues and excellences. These three jewels of the department, Dr. Mrs. Betty Daniels. I met her, I think, some 32, 33 years back, way back in 1984, 85, 86, something like that. How was this lady? She was a young lady, very simple, but highly qualified in the field of microbiology. She was a doctorate, a genius, and a scholar. But she was very innocent. Exactly what kind of a precious metal she was, I came to know when opportunities started coming towards her. Every time something was needed from her, there was no word in her dictionary called no. Immediately she would say, yes sir, panitla sir, no problem, we do it sir. So lively, because she had so much of capacity within. She steered and channelized the students by guiding them through latest and recent studies via journals and internets. And that scientific temper was created in the minds of the students. Now this is what was her greatest gift to the student. To get from you the most important energy, that temper, to become a scientist. Dr. Jacob Abraham. Is the aroma of the department. I knew him even before he came to this college. I worked under Professor Sripad Narayan Akashi in the university for my doctorate, and so did Jacob Abraham. I did in paleobotany and he did in paleontology. You know, the battle tank of US, which is one of the best in the world, is called Abraham, because it is very strong, and this man is equally very strong, physically, mentally, psychologically, and academically. He was one of the best athletes who competed at the university. And of course, he's also very strong in his voice. he, like all of you, is from this institution. So he's a Josephite. He is one of the most highly disciplined and a military type of a person I have seen. Most of us were happy-go-lucky guys, always smiling, always laughing. Not Abraham. He had his own body language. But always ready to do good at all times. Extremely important in the department when it comes to doing anything extra other than teaching. Say for example, I have to take a batch of students suddenly to Madikeri or some forest like that. Jacob ji, chale bhai, ready ho jao. Haan sir, okay sir. He's immediately there to help me. And also with the students. He's been like that. But he's a macropedia in his subject. He has digested palynology, paleobotany, especially when it comes to nature and natural resources such as oil and petroleum. His knowledge is extraordinary. Dr. Purushottama, he is a beautiful flower, but under a leaf. That was my first opinion about him. He was so simple, modest. Nobody knew that he could be an encyclopedia in mycology and plant pathology. But masked by his appearance. A person who is silent, very efficient, having depth of knowledge, a tireless worker, ready to help whenever approached by anyone. This is what he was. And I saw in him that he associated with Dr. Tamil Seeran. Together, help the department and the students come up with different honors program, MPhil programs, PhD programs. And when there was shortage, the syllabus was changed and many of the colleges in Bangalore wanted certain specimens like spirulina, zola, which was not available easily at all. So these two friends, colleagues of mine, Seeran and Purushottam, they started producing one of the best cultures, unpolluted, in large quantities, and started distributing to all the colleges who wanted those specimens. In between, they had a small hobby. They had a small dark room. Catch hold of some 2-3 students. Grow mushrooms. So the students will grow those mushrooms. He'll tell them, take it home, give it to your mother. One day, to my surprise, I see these people making this mushroom late in the evening after the classes are all over. They're doing this, and I said, what are you people doing here? Sir, we are doing mushroom soups. For whom? For the students. That was fantastic. Kind of relationship you develop. Very healthy relationship. To them, a student meant their child.
As I come to the people who are about to retire now, okay, Betty, Purushottam, and Jacob, no, yeah. Jacob is again one of our close friend, right? We used to always have a gang like thing. Myself, Bobaya, Jacob, Devagar, things like that, people like that. And personally, he's an extremely good person. And especially recently, I had an operation here. So he used to carry food from his house and give me. Right, okay, this Wilson Garden Hospital. A Jammu person that way. And very lovely person. Okay. And very good in especially planned the palynology and aerobiology, things like that. And again, a very disciplinary type of person, but very good at heart. And Betty, you know very well, right? Okay. Again, a cure of immunology, I would call that way. And also in cervical cancer, she did a PhD. And again, a nice personality. And she may blast the students, but very good at heart, right? I remember, give marks, she's extremely good, and she'll give the maximum marks. And she's very helpful, even though she may shout at you, achieve that, I'll hang you upside down, other things like that. But don't worry about those things at all. She's very good at heart. And she really wants students to improve. That's her idea. Even though she may shout at them, in the next moment she'll forget and she'll pat on their backs. She's that a very encouraging type. Again, KVP, again, right? A king of mushrooms, I call that way. He can identify any mushroom for that matter, even other fungi also. Okay, I think he did a PhD from CAS, Chennai, Anna University, or I think mushroom, Chennai. And a very, very sincere person who minds his business. He doesn't interfere with others' business, rather. Personally, he's extremely, what should I say, helpful to me. I used to call him for anything and everything, right? From Google Map to, at that time I never used to Google Map. I used to ask him how to go that place. He used to give immediately tell me the route, how to reach that place without any problem. So personally, we used to have extremely good relationship. And again, as I said to you, extremely good person who doesn't bother about other things, and he minds his business and then just get out. That's all.
Okay. I'll start in alphabetical order. Betty first. She was the one person who truly believed in the message that knock at the doors, it will open, or ask him, it will be granted to you. And she had the courage to ask not only the Lord, but the management, the colleagues, her students. And she got everything granted, meaning that everybody got benefited out of whatever she asked. She was such a kind of person. And she was the one person who had belief in all the staff members, and she had given all the responsibility to all the teachers. And in fact, she delegated responsibilities without keeping everything to herself. And that improved the department like anything. Okay, regarding KVP, Tumbida Koda Tulukwadilla, rare giant in his field. He is the one person who did everything without expecting anything as a reward. A simple, unassuming giant. Who never expected any reward for his work. He never asked for recognition. He shunned the limelight, and he was the peacekeeper of the department and the conscience keeper of the department also. He was one of our best colleague and my best friend. We had the, like I said, the same. We were in the same wavelength with Jacob. This man also was in the same wavelength with Dr. Jacob Abraham. A tall, dark, handsome gentleman of the department with an eye for perfection in everything, whatever he did. And he expected the same thing from his students also. The most decent and friendly teacher with a no-nonsense attitude. He was the most loyal staff member of SJC. You ask the management, they will watch for it. He was the only non-priest vice principal in the college. Okay, regarding the memories, it is 30 years, a long haul. I think the memories come to me flooding, but that memories of 30 years cannot be condensed and given in this short video or in a short time. The only thing that I wanted to tell to the this department is that, to the students and the teachers, that 16 or 17 members of the staff members of Botany department, we know everyone's strength and we know everyone's weaknesses also. I know somebody else's strength, I know somebody else's weakness also. They know my strength and they are knowing my weaknesses also. And nobody exploited anybody based on their weaknesses. It's always the one thing that I will cherish about my colleague is that they came to the help of every other teacher whenever they had shortcomings. They never given up any teacher in front of students. They always cooperated with the other teacher in such a way that their shortcomings will be overcome by the other people's strength. And this is the one thing that I want to tell to the department. And this has to be carried on. Then only the department will survive.
First, let me before going to the little bit of these three teachers, let me tell you, I joined in 1987. That was the PG block, which was here in the present campus where you people are. We were running from the residency road to take classes here, and we should be thankful to late, the great, the Father Nalapathy. He is one of the person who had actually the great vision about the whole institution of St. Joseph's College, and the presently what is being named as Nalapathy's Block. It is an honor to his service and contribution to this great institution. We were all were appointed at that time, a good number of students, myself, Dr. Jacob, Dr. Purushottam, Dr. Bopaya, and large number of these youngsters at that time, were appointed by Dr. Nalapathy with a great vision that this college will have a great number of achievements in the days to come. So we in fact want to tell you that it is these group of youngsters we joined had a very, very cordial relationship and very cordial environment, and because of which the Department of Botany, along with many of the senior teachers who are already there, Dr. Sundarajan, Dr. Betty, senior to me, and we in fact have grown up in this environment like a family. We never felt that we are actually an outsiders. Always this was the second home for us. The department was the second home. No politics, always we used to spend very good time. In teaching and as well as the rest of the time where we used to meet and had a good fun of time. Let me first speak about Betty. Dr. Betty, when I joined the department, I felt that she's a very tough lady, but always I realized immediately that she's a lady who is tough outside but very kind in heart. Always caring type, very a person who always prays for others, who always likes the well-being of other teachers and fellow colleagues and students. That is her nature, what I had a first impression when I joined in 1987. Now coming to her achievement, and most of you may not be aware, that is the students, that she is the one who is person who started this department of microbiology, and because of that now it has grown into a very big the area of the students, what we call the admissions and lot of activities, whatever is taking place here and whatever the achievements which is going on, it has to go to Betty, who started that with Dr. Jacob Paul and Dr. Rajamani, who are there in that department for some time, and good that all of them, they came back to the Department of Botany to be with us. She is a very resource person, being an authority on the cervical cancer. She has written one book on microbiology also. Now coming to the this one, she's one of the only lady in the college who is without any fear. She's open in her expression. My fondest memory I can tell you is she's the only the lady, daredevil lady, who can hang the students upside down without a rope, okay, without a rope, and for the mistakes being done. But the very next moment she consoles them, and very next moment she will go beyond anything to help them to come out of their mistakes, and she see to them they are wonderful persons in the society. She is always a very helping type, and lot of things she do in the background we are not aware what kind of help actually she is doing, but lot of things we are not aware, but she is always a caring type. I want to convey the wishes for all the three together, so let me go to Dr. Purushottam sir. Dr. Purushottam joined 1 year later to me. He joined in 1988. I joined in 87. He joined in 1988, 1 year later to me, along with Dr. Tamilseran. He is the most sober person in the department. Yeah. And he will speak very less, but he works very hard. And he is the person who will not comment on any such issues which are with lot of controversies. He keeps quiet, and he will not say yes or no, he will keep himself quiet. That is the impression that I got when I joined the department. Now coming to the his achievements, he is an authority on fungi. And especially his work on mushrooms and his work on orchid mycorrhiza is commendable. Has produced two theses, and some of the species and varieties of the mushrooms are new to South India, new to Bangalore. So that is his important contribution. His ability to do work very meticulously. As I told you, he will not show that he is working, but lot of work he is going to present. When once a time comes, he will present all his details very, very meticulously. And I had an opportunity to go to a tour with him, and personally to tell you, we went to Kemmangundi, and he was with me for collection of orchids, and that was a beautiful time, that along with research, okay. So we used to take our what we call our students with us. So the best time is the time we have spent together, not only in the department, even in the collection time also. So that is what this one. I call him as with a nickname even today, as Paropakari Papanna. In olden times, I think even today it may be in publication, Chandamama. In Chandamama there used to be one good story called Paropakari Papanna. Some of you may not know what is exactly that. So a person who always available for help 24/7, for any kind of help, actually that is available from him. So that is always the case. Coming to Dr. Jacob Abraham. Jacob Abraham is a sport built personality. You know, always very stiff, because he comes from a military background. His father was a military man. So always all his doings is like a tough man with a military kind of job. But he is such a wonderful person. I met him in my life. And we joined together almost, he was 1 month senior to me. I joined 1 month later. Now coming to, he always, I can tell you in two words, he is a man with sport and sportive spirit. I think many of you may not be aware that he is a state record holder for 100 meters run. Okay. He represented Bangalore University at that time. And being a Josephite who studied here, that is, I think he BSc he studied here, and that's why he carries a lot of memories actually with him, all the teachers who taught him. So that is a beautiful part he always used to share with us. Now coming to the his contributions and milestones, he is another person, authority on palynology, and especially the melitopalynology. I used to see a lot of the honey bottles inside his cupboard. I used to tease him that he is very selective in giving the honey bottle to people, and he never spared that to me. And his most liked the plant is the genus Dolichantrum. We used to fight very fondly with each other every year on one issue. That is, we two used to go to the same ecology paper, and there were some borderline topics were there where I used to go and teach that mangrove vegetation thinking that it is my area, because I did my 1 year of my mangrove research in Tamil Nadu coast. So I used to finish it fast. This fellow never used to know that. And again, after some time when he goes there to teach that topic, student used to tell him, "Sir, this is already over, this is already completed by Dr. Divakar." So he used to come to department and he used to fight with me. So that is one of the fondest memory of what I have with Dr. Jacob, of my time with him. That is my opinion. And to tell you, all the three teachers put together, I want to wish them a very happy retired life, and also they should spend good time with their families. And I also want them to keep coming to the campus, support the students, guide them, may not be officially but unofficially. So this is my opinion about all the three teachers.